And now, the Crypt Keeper of Creepy, the provocative Prince of the Tweens, the Nightmare from Neptune, it's Zabujard!
Hates me. It's almost 6 in the morning or so. It's still totally dark outside. I've got a bright red light on. They say that if you stare into red light, it reverses the effects of blindness, which, as you know, runs in my family. Blindness. Blindness runs in my family, and, but not spiritual blindness, thankfully, but, physical blindness. If you can believe that, that's how it is. Sometimes I feel alone here. I know I'm not alone, but I haven't called my mom in like 4 or 5 days or something. Or talked to her. And the end of the world is so close. It's so close. You know. I went on a walk tonight at about 1 in the morning. Haven't just been playing a card game a lot. Destroying my eyesight. Playing a MOBA on the phone. Like League of Legends. Similar to that. Just been playing that and the card game. Been praying sometimes. A good amount of time. Sometimes you feel like you're going a little loopy. I do. And I think it's from a bunch of different things, but I think the main thing could just be my lifestyle. I don't think I exercise enough. Definitely don't eat enough, don't exercise enough. I had one meal today or so. Don't exercise enough, don't eat enough. I'll just say I'm fasting again. If I don't eat enough food in the day, I just say, to heck with it, I guess I'm fasting today, right? That's my excuse. Guess I'm fasting today, because I didn't eat enough. And just being stuck in this little room for 24 hours a day, sometimes it just makes my mind, I don't know, and then there's my sleep. I'm sleeping very well, actually. A little bit too well. Now I'm starting to sleep 8 to 10 hours. I'm worried it's going to get to 12 to 15 hours at this rate. At the rate that I'm sleeping right now. Sleep has always been a weird issue for me. I stopped taking melatonin, and my sleep got better. Whereas normally you would think it would get worse without sleeping meds. Without the sleeping meds, somehow my sleep got better. I don't know. When I was a teenager, I could sleep for 12 hours. Easily. And I always have so many dreams. I was staring into red light tonight to try to help my eyesight. It reverses blindness in some studies. The evil, intoxicating look of blue light can make people go blind. Blue light is bad. Blue light is at the wave frequency of 6.66. Whatever light waves are measured in. I'm not making that up. Look up the frequent wave frequency of blue light. It says 6.66. And what a weird coinkydink that blue light makes you go blind as a bat. And it happens to have the freaking number of the devil in it. Isn't reality freaking a trip? This isn't really reality, is it, right? This shit's gonna come to a close soon anyway. This is just a show, a theater act, a circus act. This isn't reality. Real reality is where we should be in heaven with God. So the fact that we're here right now, this place is just a joke. Everybody now calls it clown world, and that's all it is, a clown shit show, right? Disgusting clown world. I can't wait to leave this place once and for all. But I've still got some things to work on. We all have things to work on, right? I really wanted to exercise today, but I just didn't. I just sat in a chair all day. I went on a walk for like 30 minutes, but I wanted to do push-ups. Every day I want to do push-ups, and I almost never do them. I just think about doing them while I sit in this chair. If you believe, they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe, there's nothing up their sleeve, nothing is cool. Doing them while I sit in this chair. And I look down at the ground and think, I should get out of the chair and do push-ups right there, but I never do. I never go on the ground. And actually, I want to do planks right now. I'm not even into push-ups right now. I actually want to do more planking and push-ups. I guess a little bit of both, but I'm not doing either. I'm just sitting in this chair and rotting away into dust. Which is, you know, strange. I really wish I could draw, but my mouse is broken. It doesn't feel right. The mouse that I have just doesn't feel very good. So I can't even draw. I can't even do anything. It's destroying my creativity. Everything is just destroyed right now. Everything's just destroyed. I haven't talked to my mom in like 5 days. I haven't talked to very many people. My sister, but it feels alone when you're in the by yourself a lot. You feel like you're alone when you don't talk to many people and you're in your room a lot and you don't go out very much. You feel like you're a little bit alone, and sometimes it's hard to deal with that sometimes, I guess. And I want you guys to know that when the world does end, if we're still here, I'm still going to be doing podcasts to myself, but I'm going to be pretending that you guys are listening to the podcast, even though the internet will be down like it is in, you know, Gaza. That'll be a worldwide thing. No internet, no electricity, no food, no water. But I want you to know I'm still going to do the podcast, and but you won't be able to hear them without internet, obviously, because there won't be internet. But telepathically, maybe you can imagine the podcast, because I reckon I'm still going to be doing them. It's just you're not going to be getting it directly from my mouth, since there won't be internet. But I think I might still do them telepathically, because I do enjoy doing podcasts in my head a lot, just to myself and to no one. And sometimes I just find myself doing them in my head. You know, I still don't even have a GUN. I still don't even have one of those things. But definitely be a good idea to get one. But I just don't even have one. I don't even know what I'm doing. One of the problems is I'm just too lazy to go out and get one. Isn't that cringe? Like, if they sold them on Amazon, of course I'd buy one, I think. but they don't sell them on in California, which is where I live, by LA, right? You can't buy them on Amazon. You have to go to the shop, and it's kind of an annoying process, but it sure would be fun to build a catapult or a trebuchet, don't you think? Anyway, it's about 6 a.m. I better get going to sleep, so I forgot what I wanted to talk to you guys about. I got brain fog like crazy sometimes, and I wish that that would go away, too. Pray for me, and I'm praying for you guys, and let's hang in there. Let's hang in there for a little longer until we're out of this stupid freaking dumpster fire, carnival, crappy amusement park ride. You know what I mean? There's all win-ors and lose-ors in these games, these party games. That word or is in so many words, O-R-E, something to be mined, minerals. I think human beings are mined for their minerals and their energy and stuff here. That's why there's lose-ors and win-ors. In the end, if you're playing the game, everyone here playing the game, you're all being played. You know what I mean? They're all being played, man. I'm playing the game. No, you're being played. I'm a win-or. No, you're a lose-or, man. It's all winners and lose-ors, man. It's just sad. It's just sad. It's all in the language, man. Even the word genius. I looked it up the other day. Genius comes from the word jinn, demon. Every genius out there just has a demon telling them what to say. Think about it. Genius. Genius. Jinn comes from the word... Is like an Islamic demon. Where do they get the word genie from? Jinny. Where they get the name Jinny from? Jenny, maybe. I don't know. Jenny from the block? Genie from the block? Jinny from the block? I wouldn't be surprised. It's where they get the word genius from. Jin us. There's a demon with people. If you don't believe me, look up Socrates. He specifically said he had a demon who told him everything that he told him to say. And whenever he made a mistake, the demon would always tell him, you made a mistake. Everybody's like, Socrates was such a genius. Yes, he was, because he literally had a demon telling him what to say 24/7. And he admitted that in his books. Don't believe me? Suck my balls. Just kidding, but look it up for yourself. I know a lot of people. I have a lot of atheist friends who don't believe a single word I say. But it was either Socrates or Aristotle. I don't remember which one. I think it was Socrates, but he was a genius, but all he did was he had a demon that told him what to say 24/7. And I'm sure that's what it's like for pretty much all the other geniuses out there, or most of them, okay? So don't think they're smarty pants, fag fucks. Don't think they're smarty pants, big smarty pants, smarter than you. Uh-oh. They could just have a demon telling them what to say. That's all I'm trying to say. God bless your family. See you guys later. Bye.
Now it's time to have a snuggle with my very best friend in the whole wide world. You. Well, I'm glad you could come over. See you soon. Bye. The clown jumped over the moon.